Welcome to CNS Focus Interview Series. Today we have a very special guest who has shaped and mentored medical experts and has been a guiding light in lives of many people. Director Professor Dr. Kishore Chandra Mohanty is widely acclaimed not only as a senior chest physician, but also highly respected as a medical teacher, physician, social worker, educationist, and as well as a spiritualist. His contribution on lung health and linking lung health to environment, life-influencing work with tribal communities in Maharashtra, leadership in engaging medical experts in far-to-reach areas like the northeastern states or Jammu and Kashmir, for instance, needs a special mention. Professor K.C. Mohanty has inspired several generations of chest physicians and medical experts as a teacher of repute. He was in conversation with CNS Managing Editor Shobha Shukla. Without any further ado, let's listen to Director Professor Dr. K.C. Mohanty.
What, according to you, have been some major game changers in the past decade in your field, which really brought about a change in the way?
In each field, there is a different milestone. Suppose you talk of spiritualism, it is a different together. Adivasi education is a different together. Mm. When you talk of I'll give you an example, Adivasi education.
Yes.
When I went to the village, if you go on YouTube, Dr. K.C. Mohanty, you'll find that about 25 years back, I went to a village around 90 kilometers from here, that is known as the Pathraj. Mm. And that time it was barren land. And not only that, the people were not well to do. Even for 15 rupees daily wages, people were not getting jobs. And they have cut down all the trees because of they wanted to survive. Mm. So what I told when I went there, I started giving them the work. I started telling them that do plantation, don't cut trees. Today, the result after 25 years, today I can proudly say, this village has got 35,000 trees. 35,000 fruit trees, bearing trees, and also stick and all the things. Not only that, which was absolutely barren today, it is greenest, and there is a lack of rainfall, but rain is increasing. Then another thing I like to tell, the economy of the village which was so bad, 15 rupees they are not getting. Today I have got 9 cars in the village, private cars. And not that they are illegal money. Mm-hmm. Why I am telling you now why? But we have been awarded by the government of Maharashtra, that is called Kanta Mukti. That means there are no criminal cases, no civil cases for 6 years, and that we got 6 lakhs. Again, as a Shantipurna Gaon, that is a peaceful village, we got a power award of another 5 years. And after that last award, 3 years have passed and there is nothing. So it is. And people didn't know how to do prayers. Today they are doing prayers, they are disciplined, and they are singing glory of the God. So what I am telling you, this is one of the game changers we have seen. Everything is possible, one we have done. As far as the tuberculosis is concerned, if you come to tuberculosis, I have tried every time to do new experiment. I don't go by the broken path. I told, why should I follow anybody? Why should not I make cure in my own way? Let's look at this. Take for example, as far as the immunity is concerned, we look at the immunity. Immunity plays a bigger part. Almost 50% of our body takes care of it, because all of us sitting now here, we have been infected by TB. But none of us have got active tuberculosis. Why? Because our immunity is intact. The moment immunity goes down, then disease starts flaring up. So we have to boost the immunity, natural immunity. That's why I have used immunomodulators. Right from the, in 1973, I started using levamazole, the anti-helminth tablet, which is used for the roundworm and all. So I started using that. After that, I have used immunoglobulins. I have used the herbal mineral, and I have used even homeopathic, because I believe in the all lives. That's yesterday, governor told, I believe in the Ayush. So I told, okay, I tried. And I found good, excellent result. My patient's survival and cure rate is much better than others. Why? I have always taken this. And I told them, I'm taking this. You want to take it, you take it, don't take it. Take for example, now, I have been telling to the people that don't give a straight jacket formula to the TB cure. government was going on giving a straitjacket for blood. The acceptability was low. Slowly, in last 3-4 years' time, I have been able to change them and make it now. It is a flexible thing. It is rather for MDR cases, XDR cases, we have got now, I am giving them tailor-made regimen. For him, is going to be very different. So this is what I have achieved. My own objective in life is that always people are afraid who will play, kick the first ball. I am the one to kick the first ball. And after I kick the first ball, I say that let others play it. Okay, I'll give one example. I think about 15 years back. 15 years back, I was coming by the side of this Mumbai, Govandi area. Usually I come from the New Bombay side. When I go to my village house, then I was coming by the New Bombay area. And I could not breathe anything. Then I came and asked the people, what is the problem? Why am I not able to breathe? Why so much of smoke is there around? Then they told me, they are burning the garbage. I told, what for? Now they want to extract the metal. They want to extract the metal. Then the Human Rights Chief, Chairman of the Human Rights Commission, was Justice Ranganath Mitra. I wrote to him, sir, you should interfere. He told, how can I interfere? I knew him, of course. So he told that, see, basic human right is that clean air to breathe, palatable and potable water to drink, unadulterated food to eat. This is the violence of the basic human right. I was so happy when the man of his stature, Chief Justice, was ex-Chief Justice. He believed and he flew to Bombay. He took a press conference, and not only that, he ordered the Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Home Minister of Maharashtra, Municipal Corporator, the Commissioner of the Bombay Municipal Corporation, that cleared it up. And that the burning stopped. Now you know, again, 2 years back, this whole same thing has started. And I was passed my MD in 1970 to get a paper introduced in a conference. It took me 6 years. And that also I could not get in a national conference. I got it in an international conference at Ceylon. And that also courtesy to one of my mentors, Dr. S.P. Tripathi. But next to give it at a paper in the National Conference of Tuberculosis at Jaipur, it was a, I tell you, Himalayan task. Okay. But then I decided, the day I took over as HOD, I told all my students must attend. And I must present at least 3 papers when they are with me. Slowly, with my stature, I grew up and I could give everybody. And since 1982, when I was only 42 years old, I have stopped presenting papers in the conference because I gave it to my juniors to present it. It is my duty that I must see that they must present 3 papers before in a conference before they go out from my department. We decided that how to give that opportunity to the more students. So we decided we must have quizzes in all over India. And we selected initially 20 quiz anchors. After the 20 quiz anchors, we did our quizzes and we gave them prizes and we sponsored their trip to attend our NESCON and after that and they go back. This time, because as I am doing the NAPON, we did it in 30 states. And 216 students have been selected by this committee. And just imagine, 216 students, and they have been all given the scholarship, and they will be given to and fro fair, and they will be competing. And I am grateful to my students, including Dr. Gilada, who is with my side now, that all of us went there, and we had a fantastic conference. How do you know that you are not going to die just sleeping on your bed?
Yes.
So why should you be afraid of anything? Never get afraid. I am not afraid of my death. You know, you'll be surprised. No, I have got a temple complex at the village I mentioned, Patras. Then 7 years back, I had made my own samadhi. Achcha. I made it because I know that is death is going to come any day. So I have told my villagers that when I die, put me here, so that nobody has to spend the money for anything. So they have agreed. So what is that? I have to accept the truth. People don't accept it, they run away from the truth. That is the one thing.
What are the challenges you have faced? You have talked about so much you have achieved, but you must have gone through the ups and downs.
Challenges are like this. First of all, I am an outsider, I came in 65. So Mumbai were difficult to accept. People didn't know where is Odisha, where is Oriya. I have to take out currency note, 10 rupees, and show them this is Oriya. And I'm telling you, and before this, my friends have, even my classmates have come. They had no courage to say that they are Oriyas and all. They will say, "Yo, Orissa, Bengal mein hai na?" Bola, "Ha." They will say, but I'm not. I will say, truth has to be told, not that I'm proud. But today somebody asked me, "Who are you?" I told, "I'm Maharashtrian." Somebody told, "I was a Oriya, but now I'm Maharashtrian." Because you want a double loyalty. See, this is what I want to tell you. So that was one of the challenges. Then the second challenge came in 1970. I passed my MD, and immediately I joined as a senior staff member, and my colleagues became my residents. You know, so neither they ran away from me. They kept maintaining distance, and I could not go near to my teachers because there was a gap. So, I was floating in the middle of the air for about 10 years until I got absorbed into the senior circle. So, that was the biggest challenge because neither you belong to this group or you belong to those group, you are only going alone. But these challenges made me tougher and I could face it and I could, looking at the thing, I could find out, innovate things. I could take up other projects. Forget what I'm telling you now. A problem is a problem. If you think it is a problem, if you think there are two things, there is nothing called that tension. There is nothing called tension. Tension is nothing. But tension is, what is there? It is a mental challenge. Anything you do is a challenge. You have to meet the challenge, accept the challenge. Without challenge, the life is no good. You must have the life. All the innovations have occurred, all the discoveries have occurred because of the challenge. And I always believe that we must prepare this next generation to take over smoothly from us. What is the most valuable thing for our life, in our life, is our own life. When you are detached from your own life, why should you bother for anything else? I don't celebrate the valley, the Dasara, no festivals I celebrate. Because for me, I am always happy. I don't celebrate because what happens, you know? I always believe every day sun is rising from the east, setting on the west, wind is blowing from the west to the east. And why should I take this particular day is good and particular day is bad? Second thing that I tell to the people, don't waste your money on the marriages, don't waste your money on the festival, don't put your Diwali, Dasara and all this. Don't show this show.
Setting an example yourself then.
You want to say, aao kare, jao mat kare, go and come, aao or jao. Aap kya bolte hai? What do you say? You said, go and do the farming. What I say, come on, let's go and do the farming. Don't wait for others to come and help you and give you, do your work. You develop your own power, own strength, and then you can help others.
What needs to be done more, some doable action so that we on the path to end tuberculosis?
I'll tell you what is required is only one step. We have to find out new drugs. Because we do not have drugs, as I told you in my lecture, we were there then last drug was discovered in 1963. Since then, there is no drug. Rifampicin was in 63. All these we are using, they are antibiotics. They have come as antibiotics, so we are using it because they are useful in India. All quinolones, all clarithromycin, azithromycin, and roxithromycin, all of them are microlides. They are all come as India. Even now we are using amoxicillin and clavulanic combination, linozolate, all these are antibiotics. We are using it because they are useful, but they are for long-term, it's not a safe drug. These are not safe drugs. So that's what I'm telling, you know, what is required is today the combined, cooperated and coordinated effort of the BRICS countries. Because BRICS countries are the worst sufferer, because the BRICS countries can do give this to an eye, but they have got scientists, they have got the patients, and they have got the manpower. And also now today, BRICS countries are well developed, so they can also pull their resources. And I will go to the extent, I have said, which I have written to the Prime Minister also, ask the Middle East to finance it. Why? Because most of the people working there are the people from the BRICS countries only. The laborers are, they're building the Middle East, so why should not they finance it? You just have to put the threat to them that you will not get good, healthy workers. We are just doing, changing the methodology, combining this and that, X and Y, nothing new has come. As far as I'm concerned, and the other one what I wanted to tell you, to spread the tuberculosis, control the spread of the tuberculosis, built multi-story sanatoria. Those MDR cases, XDR cases, XXDR cases, keep them in the sanatoria till they become negative. Because what is happening now? Each case infects 20 people in a year. And in the people staying in a half the room like this size, how they are going to save themselves? Truth is truth. It is inborn in me. It is imbibed in me. And also, I am dead once. I will not know. I am dead once on 31st March 1993, I was dead from on record 315 to 318. I know what is death. So I've experienced death. Now how beautiful. I was, I'm telling you, I had a heart attack, and in Grand Medical College, I'm on record, it is there. It has been made in television serial. So what happens, you know, then at 315, 2:30 I was admitted in ICU, and immediately I closed my eyes, I told a blanket that you do whatever you want to do, because they were all my students, they were afraid, no? Then 3:15 I left the world. I am just seeing Lord Vishnu standing on the Garuda, not sitting on the Garuda, standing on the Garuda, the Lord Vishnu, and in the deep blue universe. I was looking at him, I am smiling, and I just merged with him. So I can vividly now can see that scene here in my front of my eyes. I'll see, I can see what I've seen. So, what is there? You have to merge with the universe. What is death? After all, we have been born out of something. And we have to merge with it. Why should we be afraid so much? Truth has to come. I don't want to be invalid. I don't want to be at the mercy of the others. That is the most pitiable. I tell to God, I am ready to, I have packed my luggage, I have everything, I am ready to come to you. But don't make me invalid by any chance.
You were listening to Director Professor Dr. K.C. Mohanty, who was in conversation with CNS Managing Editor Shobha Shukla. For more details, be welcome to visit us at www.citizen-news.org. Thanks for listening and stay tuned.